السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. We're still in the journey of the summer 1992 going from Qatar to Bahrain to raise the awareness of the people of Bahrain about the issue of Bosnia. We arrived in Bahrain, were welcomed by Jamiat al-Islah, which is headed by one of the royal families, member of the royal family in Bahrain at the time. And the program was extremely comprehensive, start from 9 o'clock in the morning and ended by actually midnight or before midnight or after midnight, because the young people in Bahrain are very active and proactive and actually progressive. So we managed while we were there to make a lot of interviews with radio, with newspapers, with television. Even we met the Sheikh of Bahrain, Sheikh Isa, may Allah bless his soul. Then we met the Minister of Awqaf or Endowment as well as many businessmen who are actually greeting us and inviting us to come and visit their families at home as a kind of hospitality at that time. When we met the Sheikh of Bahrain at the time, Sheikh Isa bin Khalifa, rahmatullah alayh, he gave us a gift, which is a golden watch for me and the golden watch for Sheikh Saleh Julakovic as well. I couldn't be able I don't know what to do with my golden watch, but later on I took it with me to Qatar and they sold it for about 6 or 7,000 riyal at that time, because I couldn't be able to wear it. It's too expensive for me at that time. At that time, I used to carry with me what we call it a plastic bag. Inside the plastic bag, a piece of rug from a mosque, as well as a part of a chandelier to tell, because I visited one of the mosques who had been totally destroyed and destroyed by the fighting in Bosnia. And I was just showing them the extent of destruction and damage affecting the mosques in this area. I used to carry it from a place to a place and from a town to a town and from house to house. Then we visited the Minister of Awqaf or Endowment, who gave us a grant of $150,000 at that time for the Bosnia case. Jazakumullah khair. Apart from that, the young volunteers of this organization were taking us to different families, very, very hospitable people, very open-minded and very cultural people, and it's an open society at that time. While I was there, I was writing telegraph to because I wanted to go to Kuwait, and I didn't have any contact in Kuwait. We planned to, after Bahrain, to visit Emirates. We were sponsored by one of the local organizations called Islamic Charity Organization in Dubai, and another organization called Hayat Abu Zabi I'm not sure if it was started at the time or not. It was actually Islamic Relief Organization in Dubai, not Abu Zabi. So we finished our visit in Bahrain. Was very successful one, extremely successful one, and we moved to Dubai and then to Abu Dhabi. And we were visiting all the small organization there in Dubai as well, and waiting for confirmation to come to us from Kuwait about our next visit there. And while we were there, we given the permission to visit the chair of the royal court in Abu Dhabi, and we visited him to explain to him what's happening in Bosnia at that time. Alhamdulillah, could not be able to visit the sheikhs of Abu Dhabi, but at least we visited this top individual in the country who can brief the sheikhs of Abu Dhabi as well. While we were there, we received the confirmation to go to Kuwait. And alhamdulillah, I was very joyful and very happy to complete the journey and to go to Kuwait as well. My brothers in Dubai, when they realize I'm going to Kuwait and they look at me not having any, not wearing any suits, they told me you can't go to Kuwait wearing a shirt and trousers and with this miserable looking look of you. You have to buy a few suits for yourself. At the time, some of the businessmen gave me a gift of Bosht, which is one of the dresses actually the Arabs wear, is very expensive. I gave it to the man, told me, give it to me, and I'll buy it from you. And with what you, I gave you money, go and buy for yourself two suits, because you don't go to Kuwait with a shirt and trousers. I did listen to his advice, and I bought the two suits, and we traveled afterwards to Kuwait. We did not realize that we were hosted, or were the guest of the Crown Prince of Kuwait, the late Sheikh Saad Al Abdullah rahmatullah alayh, after the Amir, the late Amir Sheikh Al Jaber, asked him to receive us. In Kuwait was more organized because the organization have done their duty and they send a lot of money, millions and millions of pounds, and got too many organizations there, more established than the organizations in Kuwait, in Bahrain and in Qatar. And we, alhamdulillah, managed to make one or two press conferences, meeting businessmen, meeting organization, meeting other people, as well as meeting the Crown Prince himself. To meet the Crown Prince, he has to be briefed by the Minister of Awqaf to tell him what's Bosnia, what's happening there and here and there and here. And alhamdulillah, the briefing happened before we arrived, and we went together to meet His Royal Highness, the Crown Prince, the late Crown Prince of Kuwait at the time, Sheikh Saad Al Abdullah, Jazakallah Khair. And we ended our journey or our visit to Kuwait going back to Egypt. But actually, astonishingly enough, we did not realize when we were in the airplane that we'd be met by the high-level reception by the government. So when the plane landed in Kuwait Airport, International Airport, they called out our names, and the people from the government came to look for us. They were thinking that they're coming to see some top-class people coming from here and there. In the first class or in the business class, but there was no first class, there was no business class, we were actually in the economy class. And we came down with them, and one of the top businessmen came to receive us in the airport in the VVIP hall, and took us in his Rolls Royce car, surrounded by actually this motorcycles and like a parade to go to the palace as the emirs or the vice emirs. Guests. And this is how I've been received, alhamdulillah, and welcomed and respected in these countries, actually, before we start our last part of our journey in Egypt. I'll see you next episode, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.